So yeah, that was kind of the real switch up of just like the Phoenix Rachel Rose shift. And that doesn't mean that I'm not proud of Rachel Rose and like who she is as a human being. It's just I needed a blanket. I needed something that I could keep safe with. I'm writing some of the best music I've ever written, and I think it's because I'm connecting to who what I actually want to say, not what I think I should say. And
Knowing what you know now, what advice would you give your younger self?
I would tell her to stay true to the kid who fell in love with music, stay true to the kid who used to just sing in the playground because she loved it, stay true to the words in your soul, stay true to all the goodness in you, and stay true to your story. Your story has value, and your existence has value, and you don't need to become something else. You don't have to be smaller, quieter, louder, different, happier. You don't have to be any of that. Just be true and you will find your way. And I used to question, when I was in my victim mentality, it was very like, why? Why has this all happened to me? Why is everything so hard for me? Blah, 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 blah. But actually, if I hadn't been through everything that I'd been through, I wouldn't be able to do this. And I have, and I teach from a place of understanding, not, like I said, not from a, like, it's not like I read it in a book. Obviously I did do studying, but when people say like, oh, you won't get it, I feel like this, and I went, no, I get it. Nope, you're allowed to feel that way. I totally understand. It's because, I might be able to say, oh, it's because X, Y, Z, and then they're like, oh my God, you see me, you understand me, I make sense. And I'm like, yeah, of course you make sense. And I think that's what people want to feel. In your own darkness, like we all carry darkness, right? We're made up of two things. We're yin and yang, we're made up of darkness and light. People are afraid of their own darkness. People are afraid of their own trauma, their pain, their bad habits, their nasty things, like whatever it is. But actually, that's the part of us that needs love the most. Shine light on it and go, you're not alone. Bring it out. Shame can't survive in the oxygen. It's like vampires, right? When shame comes into the air and we say it out loud and we bring compassion to it, it dies. And that's a big thing as well. It's just like making people not feel judged in their moments of shame.
I'm so grateful for you taking the time to join me on the podcast today. My hope is if only one person listens, they'll get something from your wisdom.
I really hope so.
And I look forward to listening to your song.